Hey guys, welcome back. This is JM and welcome back to Fallout 4 Survival Mode. In this episode, we are finally going back into the wasteland. It's time to continue our journey and trying to find our child. On the off camera, I've pretty much done nothing but decorating the place. I want this settlement to look cool, and I've managed to get up a few turrets. There's one on the roof of my house and another one there. And then I've just put some decoration, neon signs, and a little arrow sign. Also, I've been starting to make trade routes to different settlements. And what I am actually gonna do is order this guy. Wait a minute. Why can't I not send that to Overland? Wait a minute, what settlement is on trouble? Oh, this one. Oh, I actually thought I had another one. It's Ten Pines Bluff. Another day of hard work. Well, never mind then. Let's see if there's any racer grain or carrots ready. No, there is not. So, then we are pretty much ready to go. I'm gonna take a little night rest first before we head out. Sleep a nice 8 hours. Come on. There we go. You feel ill? Well, now we can take a first antibiotic. Let's drink.
Things are tough now, but they'll get better.
And then we'll also grab some food. Let's take the antibiotics first. Some moldy food. Am I already well fed? Now I am. And also drink a little more. There we go. Okay, let's do a quick save so I don't have to redo all that if we die early. Alright, and Doc Meat is with me, and I got my rifle and my pistol. Also got the flare gun if in case we need help. Hey, another settler!
Hey, I just wanted to introduce myself. I wanted to personally thank you for giving us this opportunity. So, let me know if you have anything you need me to do.
Yeah. Let me show you.
Okay.
I'm just gonna assign you to take care of the crops. Guess I had those two other settlers taking care of the crops, but they are both on the supply lines now. Oh wait, oh, just one of them is, actually. I was going to send this one, but... And I will. I will send him. You will be starting a trade route to Ten Pines Bluff. You become a provisioner. Nice. What if I talk to you?
I just want to trade a few things.
Oh, it's just trading. Alright, now we're gonna head out. I will go through Congard again and go through the route where the trader is. I don't remember its name. That's the place where was that two chem merchants, and then those, then the boy and the trader. Just a quick visit at the truck stop, see if there's anything I can do to my weapons. No, there isn't. And actually, I just might take the power armor with me. I don't have a lot of fusion cores, but it doesn't matter. I'm gonna also take the baseball bat. And let's see if we can upgrade that one. No, we can't. What do we miss? Adhesive, of course. It's nice to have a little melee weapon with us. But yeah, like I said, I don't have much fusion core, so we might just ditch the power armor along the way, but we have a working one. No, I didn't want to take those. But we do have a working weapon, power armor at the sanctuary, and we will come back for it someday. let's hop in and move on. We will just ditch the power on along the way when we run out of fusion cores. We will probably head back to Sanctuary once we've finished up some quests near Diamond City, and especially when we get to do the quest Tradecraft, I think it was, where you get that very cool looking and powerful pistol. Don't remember its name, but when we do that quest, it brings us back to Lexington, and then it would be a good time to return to Sanctuary and see how the people are doing in there. I actually know that there's a little place here where we can find some good loot. Where is it so foggy in here that I can't see? Can't hit anything. There we go. Thank God I have the power armor. Otherwise I might have died already. Couple of hits from a ghoul can kill us. Now let's head down to the basement. There's a unique NPC. Well, it's not an NPC, just an enemy, but there's a unique ghoul down here, and I think he was trying to create a his own mini nuke. Let's grab take some of the scrap so we can actually upgrade our baseball bat here. Okay, I think I have enough scrap to do it, but let's clear out the room down here first. You actually took quite many hits. Some duct tape, alarm clock, Nuka-Cola, bottle cap mine, nice. And the worst survival guide you can find. Let's hop out of the power armor for a sec. You all know what this reminds of. But let's do the spiked one. Let's do this. Attack these items. There we go. Our bat is ready. And moving on. Actually, I'm also gonna take this and put it here, and this and put it here. There we go. Okay, let's try to find our way back to the road. Should be somewhere here. Yep. Really hard to navigate here when it's so foggy. It's just a little campfire there. Yeah, come on. Okay, let's climb up here, see what we find. I know what's gonna happen now. When you come up here, it spawns two or three raiders in there.
I'll find you.
There we go. You guys had nothing. We might as well go talk to the trader in here. Got a lot of carry weight on me, so let's see if there's anything I should sell. Truly was her name.
That's open. What do you want?
Sure. Let's take a look.
All salvage, but nothing's junk.
Okay, let's see. Gas canister, that's too heavy. These things doesn't weigh anything. That's funny. I always get something on my throat when I start recording something. Every time the same. This weighs too much. This we don't need. Neither we need these. Well, I don't have a shotgun with me, so I can just sell these. Okay, that should be it. Moving on. Time to check out that house. Is the random encounter reset yet? Angie, who the hell is that? Oh.
Don't come any closer, friend. This doesn't concern you.
Please, help! They're going to kill me!
Shut up!
Come on, where's the dialogue?
Look, I'm sure we can work this out. No one has to die.
Fat chance! This synth has been watching us for weeks, knows everything about us. We let this thing go. How long before it comes back with its institute buddies to put us down? Why the hell would we risk that?
He hasn't hurt you yet.
You need to let him go. Think about it. If he meant to hurt you, wouldn't he have done it already?
I would never do that. You're my friends.
They got a point, Fred.
He's had all the chances in the world to harm us. Maybe we should just let him go.
All right. But if I ever see you again, I'm putting one right between your eyes.
Oh my god. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Just get the hell out of here.
Bunker this here. Doesn't come back to bite us.
I just have to make it to Bunker.
He was our friend. I was gonna do it.
Hey there.
How about you move along?
All right. I'll be on my way. Now we can get some more loot. We have the wicked trailer keys with us. All right, pretty much nothing. I think I'm gonna go through Lexington and head to the road where we ended up when we ran out of the plant. I think I'm gonna follow that road. Gotta be careful to not have I killed all the ghouls here yet. And also I haven't killed the raiders yet. I'm not gonna go visit the guy that already killed me once in the previous episodes, but I think I'm gonna try and take on the guy on the bridge over there. Not a lot of damage. But also he can't see us this far. Where'd he go? There he is. Come out. Alright, now I'm gonna try to get him with the critical shot next time. I could just land a critical hit on him. No, that's the wrong one. Oh shit, he has the mini nuke on him. And it's the fat man. Okay, let's not critical hit. And it worked. There we go. Now we just need to find our way up there. But now there shouldn't be anything but ghouls left here. Take a sip of water and heal myself with it. Not a lot of damage. That's nice. I think I'm gonna try out that Fat Man before I just drop it. But I'm gonna try it out first. As long as I have the power armor, I can carry it with me. Quick save. I know there's a couple of more ghouls down here. Blah. Actually, I know where I'm gonna test the mini nuke. There was the house before, by this road where we saw those raiders in scavengers fighting each other. And if there's hostiles there now, I'm gonna try out the mini nuke in there. Okay, what was that? Are they gunners? Another Minutemen. Let's not fire on them.
All quiet, General.
Good job, good job. Check the upstairs. Okay, there's a nearby place here, and I know there's a possible legendary rat scorpion spawn. It's not so scary on the earlier levels if I'm carrying a power armor. So I'm might gonna go test it out, but first I'm gonna get in that truck stop, a gas station in there, and save the game. I know that there's a mattress up there. Wait a minute, how good was my rifle? It's heavy. I think we are gonna find a better one up here. It's a hardened sniper rifle. It's always there, so, and it's always in the same condition. So if you're looking for a decent sniper rifle early, but you don't want to make one yourself, here is a free spot for it. Hardened sniper rifle, yes. 67 damage, as this has 58, so we are gonna change it. And now I'm just gonna quickly save here. We are a little tired. Actually, if I get the chance, I might gonna try out the Fat Man on the Scorpion, if it's a legendary. It's not always a legendary, it's not a 100% spawn. If you don't have a power armor, one easy way to deal with it is to jump on that truck, get on that roof, and you can just spam some Molotovs on the Rat Scorpion. Okay, it should be spawning here. There it is, and it's not even a legendary. Where are you gonna jump out? Behind me, of course. Man, I hate these fucking things. They creep the fuck out of me. Get away from me! Get a fuck away from me! I doubt it can get on this. Nope, it can't. Those things freak me out. They are so fucking ugly. Now I'm gonna fire this thing. Be careful, there are a lot of frag mines around here. And a lot of ghouls. I don't think I can survive a frag mine even with power armor. This is a difficult place, it's always been. There's so many ghouls that go into that police station, and one of them could be a reaver. It can one-shot me. I think it can one-shot me even with power armor. But it will, at least without power armor. Here and save the game before we head to the police station. I'm not even over impure, I thought I was. Well, now I am. Said it too early. Toll schedule. I'm gonna read that later. Okay, let's head to the police station. plant some frag mines. Alright, that was a mistake. That's the pistol I want. Best pistol in the game, I think. The VAT cost in VAT is so low, you can like, even with low agility, fire like 12 rounds with that. Okay, now we just have to do this again. Without power armor, what I've usually done here is I've gone to the little open area next to that police station and jumped on into a little sign in there and always shot from there. Usually the ghouls can't hit you that high. Wait. No. Why? Why did you have to fucking step on my frag mine and kill me? But okay. Clearly we can handle the situation. We can clearly handle it. This time I just have to put on the frag mines a little longer. You step on my fucking mine and don't even die or get hurt, but you decide to turn on me. Dude, that was not nice. Is that the stalker already? No fucking way! No fucking way! You died to a fucking scratch. This is what I meant. This is a fucking difficult mission. And very frustrating if you don't have a power armor. Because you get killed by two roamers in a second when they get near you.
More! Over there!
Here, go ahead. All right, this time we did it. Ooh.
Hey there.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Sanctuary Hills, on the other side of Concord.
I've seen the location on our maps, but I've never visited the area myself. There isn't much over there for us to collect. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
That all depends. How much are you paying?
We need allies, not opportunistic mercenaries. I have no inclination to pay for your services.
I'll continue to help, but you owe me an explanation first.
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty, but I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
I can give you a helping hand.
Halen, take Reese inside and find his wound.
Yes, sir.
Reese. Night Keen. Don't remember seeing a laser rifle. Yes.
It's time to prove your work. Head into the police station at least once. Let me know.
Early laser rifle is a welcoming thing. Carry weight. It's actually still not bad. Where are all the stalker buddies? Well, never mind. Let's head inside. It will give us this mission where we go to ArcJet Systems, but we don't have time for that. Not in this episode. We will do the ArcJet System mission on the next one.
And dance.
You ready to move out?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Just get yourself together. We've got a job to do.
Well, geez. I don't think there was a weapon workbench here, but I think I'm gonna save all the items I found from here to the there's a parking garage on downstairs, and there's a power armor frame there. Power armor stand, I think. I was correct, there isn't any weapon workbenches here, unfortunately. But then again, in the Arcjit system, there is. Okay, change of plans. I'm not gonna leave my items here. I take them with me to the Arcjit systems and upgrade my weapons there. Alright! That's normal. Yeah. Alright guys, I think that's all the time I have for this episode. In the next episode we are going into the Arcjit system like I told you. And leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!